Hi students, today's lesson is Role and Functions of Gerontologist. This lesson is about the role and functions of gerontologist. The major purpose of this text is to understand the role and responsibilities of gerontologist in the field of gerontology. It also elucidates the elements, trends and challenges involved in the practice of gerontology. On the completion of this lesson, you should be able to understand the meaning of the term of gerontologist, and you can analyze trends and challenges in gerontological practice. You to know the role and functions of gerontologists, and you can comprehend gerontology as a specialized field of practice. Who is a gerontologist? Professionals with an educational background or a professional practice orientation to aging and work with older adults are most commonly called as gerontologists. Gerontologists include researchers and practitioners in the field of social sciences, biological and medical sciences. We can organize the professionals who work with on behalf of the elders in these three categories. One is gerontology workers. They have no formal gerontological education or training, even though they work directly with or on behalf of the elderly clients or in an aging specific organization. They may play in a paraprofessional roles such as certified nurse assistants in a nursing home or as a professionals who are fully credentialed in the fields other than gerontology. And next one, gerontological specialist. They have completed at least one degree in a discipline or a professional field that is not gerontology specific but includes a formal gerontology degree component, or they obtain specialized postgraduate gerontology training that enhances the field of study in which they received their degree. And final one, gerontologists. They have earned degrees for which gerontology, aging studies or geriatrics was the primary, not the secondary field of study. This relatively new category of gerontology professionals is the result of an increasing number of degree programs in gerontology, aging studies or a similar degrees. Currently, it appears that many gerontology specific and related paraprofessionals and professional services are providing by persons who are either gerontology workers or gerontology specialist. The profession of gerontology is changing as more and growing profession to help the elder persons. Let me know, where do gerontological specialists work? The range of specific places where gerontological specialists and gerontologists are employed is too extensive to discuss here, although it is possible to suggest some of the most common types of work settings. Number one is educational setting. This is both public and private, community and colleges, universities, technical or vocational and professional schools, foundations that focus on aging and provide educational program and services to older adults, adult education and older learning programs, libraries and information centers, employee training or education divisions in the industry and corporate settings, patient education services in medical centers or clinics, and community-based agencies related to the physical and mental health. And next one is organizations. Professional organizations, conference, management and training programs, chronic disease or disorder organizations, associations and foundations, race or ethnicity specific councils on aging, gender specific organizations and initiatives, membership organizations for the older persons or etc. And medical care settings. In this setting, they can offer both rehabilitation and residential services in different institutions like adult day care centers, long-term care and assisted living centers, hospitals or medical centers, mental health facilities and veterans affairs hospitals, rehabilitation centers in home care agencies and series, and residential communities and facilities. Retirement communities including continuing care, retirement centers and other types of senior living residences, kinship care housing centers, co-housing for elders, age-friendly neighborhoods, communities and cities, etc. And government agencies. Government departments like divisions or bureaus on aging, social welfare departments, social security administration offices, medical care and medical aid service centers and assistance programs, National Institute of Health, research institutes including Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, etc. are the different government agencies that can provide an opportunity to work with older people. And corporate industry and business settings. Corporate sectors like banks, financial planning institutes and services, investment firms and brokerages, law institutes and legal assistance services, insurance industry, manufacturing hubs, etc. provide an opportunity to the gerontological professionals under the corporate social responsibility or the other form of assistance to the older adults. And final one, non-government organizations. The most of the works of the gerontologists occur in NGOs, that is civil society organizations, community-based organizations, and many of the NGOs are working for the betterment of older people. In this context, gerontological professionals are required to work with the aged people in the above sector. There is an enormous scope to work with the elder people and to enhance their happiness and joy for a long time. Gerontology is one of the growing fields of practice where many trained professionals are required in future due to the rapid growth of older persons and their problems. Let me know gerontology as a field of study and as a profession. Many of us, we have a doubt, it is a field of study or a profession. So gerontology is one of the many new academic disciplines that have emerged in modern times. It fulfills all the criteria for a field of study to become a discipline. Gerontology, defined nearly a century ago as a scientific study of old age, has been transformed from a proto-discipline, an actual discipline, dedicated to the study of aging from the broadest perspective and expanding and integrating its knowledge bases. Additionally, a discipline consists of a body of fundamental knowledge bases with a unique philosophical perspective and its own terminology. In the case of gerontology, this body of knowledge derives from three interrelated factors. The first one is need. The demographic revolution that modern Western society has undergone is characterized by rapid changes and shifts in demographic patterns and a rise in the proportion of the aged in the population, especially the old. These necessities highlighting public and professional awareness of new needs by means of the creation of specific knowledge bases. The second one is recognition of the need. A social policy in developed countries have come to recognize the need to provide quality care to the growing aged population. As shown by the accelerated development of long-term care systems, the designation of 1999 as an international year of older persons by United Nations was a significant sign of the recognition of this need. And also in our Indian government in 1999 proposed a national policy for older population. The last factor is acting upon the need. Gerontological knowledge combined in recent decades is reflected in the wide range of education and training program that have evolved in response to the need to the train researchers, educators, and professionals to serve the growing and diverse elderly populations. Concludingly, if the definition of a discipline as a profession or occupation with a shared knowledge and skills is accepted, then gerontology also marks its transition toward becoming a profession as well as a discipline. Let me discuss the common elements of gerontology practice. Despite the many social and cultural differences between countries, there does appear to be a common set of characteristics to gerontological practice. These elements that appear to be common across all countries are as follows. Number one is elder maltreatment. Abuse of the elderly is found in almost all countries of the world. According to the World Health Organization, elder abuse is expected to continue to increase and reducing the happiness of the aged. Throughout the world, both elderly men and women are high at risk of abuse, neglect, and exploitation. The World Health Organization estimates that 4% to 6% of the elderly have experienced abuse in the home and that elderly are also at risk of abuse in institutions such as hospitals, nursing homes, and other long-term care facilities. Cultural and socioeconomic factors also appear to play an important role in elder abuse. Migration of young couples to other areas, leaving elderly parents alone in societies where older people were traditionally cared for by their offspring. In this context, elder maltreatment needs to be addressed and it provides a scope to gerontological practice. And social services. Countries that deliver social services to the elderly most commonly do so through existing health and social service organizations. These generally include medical, legal, psychological, and financial help, as well as help with housing and other environmental issues. Because older persons who are more socially integrated, they can enjoy a higher quality of life and better health. There is an emphasis on providing the elderly with the emotional and practical resources known to positively impact the aging process. These often include social clubs, religious activities, and family-based activities. Another one is economic services. Across the globe, the impact of population aging is increasing evident in the old age dependency or burden on potential workers. The rising of dependency burden is most noticeable in Europe and Japan, and least noticeable in Africa and the Middle East. Reality, it is existed in nearly all countries. In addition to that, mounting dependency burden ratio in many countries, traditional family support mechanisms are being eroded due to the declining family size, rural to urban migration, urbanization, and declining co-residence, and in some countries, younger family members dying of HIV/AIDS. As a result, many older people, and particularly older women, are facing with isolation, abandonment, loneliness, and no means of financial support. The potential socio-economic impact on society that may result from an increasing old-age dependency ratio and other social shifts is an area of growing concern. Another important one is health services. Chronic and infectious diseases, many of which are direct result of life course events, influence the quality of life in older age. This condition experienced by older people vary by country or region, economic status, and gender, race, and ethnicity. In general, however, throughout the world, those elder persons with higher incomes report their health as being much better than the older people with less income. Long-term care for the elderly has been a challenge for all countries around the globe, and the challenge will increase substantially in the years to come. Long-term health care for the elderly is problematic even in those countries that have traditionally placed a high value on the elderly. Most East Asian governments promote care for the aged as a family responsibility. Many Asian governments are now exploring the need to introduce national policies on aging and long-term care to augment the traditional system. Like in India, we are introducing in 1999 national policy on older people to serve the older people. All these common elements of the gerontological practice are required attention of the governments and non-governmental organizations for reducing the alarming problems of elderly populations. Let me discuss about trends in gerontological practice. Number one is community-based care. To meet the needs of the older people, most countries have moved toward community-based care as a means of providing adequate and cost-effective care. Community-based care focuses around an integrated and more comprehensive approach to the special needs of older persons, their families, and the community. This type of model involves and requires inter-organizational collaboration and interdisciplinary cooperation. Community health care usually includes prevention, curative care, rehabilitation, palliative care, and terminal care. These integrated series may be delivered in a variety of settings, including home or housing care settings. Another one is familial support. In many places throughout the world, families are faced with increasing pressure to provide care for their elderly family members. As a result, several countries adopted familial support legislations. In India, the Maintenance and Welfare of Parents and Senior Citizens Act 2007 directing that maintenance of parents and senior citizens as an obligation of the children and violate this act will be punishable. In addition to that, recently, son and daughter-in-law are also included in this act. However, recent research indicates that policies that require or encourage relatives to provide care maybe have opposing consequences for elderly people and their families. Let me discuss the role and functions of gerontologists. Role of the gerontologist. Gerontologists are playing a number of roles for well-being of older persons. A gerontologist might find themselves counseling older adults, challenging common misconceptions about the aging, researching the effects of aging or diseases that affect the older adults, teaching in a university setting, or advocating for better services and care for the aging, according to the Careers in Aging Opportunities and Options by David A. Peterson and others. Gerontologists usually fit into 7 job roles. Number one is advocate. An advocate works to inform audiences about the issues of concerns. They work with older adults to raise awareness about their needs and concerns and appropriate responses to those concerns. An advocate should have a strong passion for working with older adults and a drive to help others. And direct service provider. A direct service provider cares for and interacts with older adults to assist them with everyday life. This can include issues related to mobility, speech, learning, and preparing meals, etc. Educator or trainer. Working in colleges and universities, an educator teaches future gerontologists. An educator usually has an experience in the field and imparts this wisdom on a new generation of gerontologists. And manager and administrator. A manager or administrator is a broad title, but managers are needed to run facilities that care for older adults. A manager or administrator is usually an experienced gerontologist with a background in business management. Marketer and the program developer. Marketers with a focus in gerontology are needed to help develop new products and services directed at the older adults. Marketers analyze the needs of the aging to determine where services are lacking and work with the program developers to take care of those concerns. And program planners and the evaluators. Program planners and evaluators ensure programs are working to the best of their abilities to address the needs of the older adults. They work with residential communities to ensure those needs are being met and adjust program if need to be addressed. And researcher. A gerontological researcher helps to understand the effects of aging and the aging process itself. Biogerontology is usually devoted to research in universities or laboratories. Researchers focus on conducting empirically based studies that provide important insights and new information to other gerontologists. Functions of gerontologists. Gerontologists are performed different functions in the process of providing care and support to older people and their families. Through a combination of psychosocial assessments, care coordination services, counseling and therapeutic work, crisis management and interventions, and discharge planning, etc. Psychosocial assessments. Gerontologists conduct psychosocial assessments to determine their clients' mental, emotional and social needs and to understand how these needs connect with their physical health and medical conditions. By gaining a holistic picture of clients' mental, emotional and social circumstances, gerontologists help older persons, medical care providers and their families better understand how to develop a care plan that is as comprehensive and concerned as possible. These risk assessments help gerontologists and other members of an older person's care team determine the appropriate courses of action to address factors that may seriously compromise an older person's well-being. Is care one of the most important functions and responsibilities that gerontologists have is care coordination, which is defined as the purposeful organization of different teams and services in order to effectively address an older person's overall health care needs, that is physical, cognitive, emotional and social. Care coordination involves not only completing psychosocial assessments to inform the larger treatment team of an older person's needs, but also participating in or facilitating meetings between the different providers to discuss patient treatment and health outcomes, conveying the concerns and desires of the patient and his or her family to the teams involved in their care, and connecting clients and their caretakers with resources within the larger community that can provide additional support. Another one is counseling and therapy. Gerontologists provide counseling and therapy to clients to help them to cope with the psychological, emotional, social and financial challenges that come with the aging. During their sessions with the elderly clients, gerontologists can employ a variety of different psychotherapeutic requirements to help their clients manage negative emotions, set objectives for life improvement, address behavioral problems or psychological barriers to meeting these certain goals, and make end-of-life preparations. When working with the families of their clients, gerontologists may help them manage the various difficulties they can encounter around caring for an aging loved one. Specific therapeutic techniques that our gerontologists may use in their work with the clients and families, including cognitive behavioral therapy and dialectical behavioral therapy and problem solving therapy, motivational interviewing and mindful based stress reduction, etc. These therapeutic techniques are not limited. As a gerontological therapist, you can use as many as possible according to the requirements in your practice. Another one is crisis management and interventions. Depending on their role and work setting, gerontologists may encounter a variety of client crisis situations. For example, some clients may struggle with severe depression and are suicidal desires, family conflicts about treatment decisions, traumatic experiences that require immediate support, or a mental or emotional disorders that pose a danger to themselves. Instances, elderly clients may be the victims of neglect, domestic abuse, exploitation and other crimes. In these occasions, gerontologists may have to intervene through a number of measures to ensure client safety and well-being. Such measures may include providing emotional support and counseling to clients and their family members as needed, managing difficult conversations between the client, family and care providers as necessary, contacting relevant organizations or the authorities in the case of elder abuse, and developing a short and long-term support plan for the clients and their loved ones. And resource guidance. Gerontologist also helps clients and their families understand and apply for healthcare benefits, as well as other financial or social assistance at the central, state, and local community levels. Clients and their loved ones may have a hard time navigating health insurance benefits, applying for medical care and our medical aid benefits, and making the use of the community support systems, etc. Gerontologists can guide clients through these steps and connect them with local support systems, such as senior centers, discounted counseling, free community clinics, and subsidized food and housing if necessary, discharge services and functions, consistent with their role as care coordinators. Gerontologists are often responsible for developing and coordinating a discharge plan for clients when the time comes from them to transition from one care setting to another. For example, from inpatient to outpatient care, or from the residential care to home care, when coordinating an older person's discharge from a care setting, gerontologists typically contact the relevant parties involved in the transition and organize logistics such as transportation, health insurance, and medical financial aid, and paperwork and other all documentations. They may also consult with the client and his or her family members in order to prepare them for the change. Challenges in gerontological practice. Increased interdisciplinary collaboration. Aging is a development issue by 2050. The number of persons aged 60 and over is projected to increase from 600 million to 2 billion. If countries are to meet these challenges and opportunities, they must start an interdisciplinary collaboration with all allied sectors. They need to build the infrastructure that will enable them to deliver a sufficient supply of appropriate healthcare, housing, income support, transportation, and other elements necessary for the quality of life for their older populations. In other words, we need to build an aged-friendly cities. This will be requiring researchers, educators, practitioners, planners, and administrators to collaborate effectively based on the emerging knowledge and best practice. Another one is development of culturally relevant practice. The form of gerontological practice that develops in any society is shaped by the prevailing social, economic, and cultural forces. But most cultures around the world are responding to the challenges of rapidly changing social and economic forces in their countries. Extreme cultural fluctuations, such as intercultural migration, inter-ethnic marriages, reducing family size, and individual mobility are impacting gerontological practice. Practitioners, researchers, and educators must develop methods that build on and reinforce those cultural values that promote the well-being of the elderly from all cultural and ethnic groups. Working out an understanding of human beings and personal development that incorporate cultural conception and beliefs is critical to effective practice with the elderly, particularly in a global context. And promotion of healthy and active aging. Active aging is an idea that has come as a response to the successful aging by stressing opportunity rather than performance and focusing on quality of life. The World Health Organization uses the phrase active aging, which it defines as the process of optimizing opportunities for health, participation, and security in order to enhance quality of life as people age. Healthy and active lifestyles throughout the lifespan to contribute positively to the aging process. As a result, the field of gerontology is beginning to try to change the concept of old age from a period of loss to a time of enjoyment, from a time of disease and incapacity to days of a healthy and active lifestyle. Governments and international organizations need to work together for promoting active aging and healthy aging. It is a recent and challenging trend to promote the well-being of older people in the coming years. The new and younger generations have a clear responsibility to promote active aging and maintain their elderly active and participative. Now, let me discuss the challenges for the future. Several significant challenges require to the introduction of policies and programs that respond to older people's needs. The governments and international organizations are required to remember these issues while they are preparing policies for interest of older people. These challenges include promoting lifelong education and training and healthy and active aging, recognizing and supporting the caregiving services provided by older persons, especially women, to grandchildren orphaned by the effects of HIV/AIDS, eliminating violence and other crimes against older persons who are caught in conflict and other complex humanitarian situations, supporting gender-sensitive research on population aging, strengthening social protection schemes for older persons, particularly the long-term care of the frail and poor, need to build age-friendly cities and infrastructure for the better access of aged population. Societies need to recognize the strengths of older persons and empower them. Human rights, sustainable human development, poverty eradication, and improved healthcare program must be developed, designed, and monitored at all levels. Gerontological professionals are required to accept the different changes and need to work for the betterment of the aged. There is a need for continued research in the field of gerontology. It is also one of our greatest challenges. As a gerontologist, it is our responsibility to understand how humans, especially the elderly, change as they continue to age. When choosing a career within the field of gerontology, you can choose to study within the areas of psychology, sociology, biology, and healthcare. Professionals from the social work and healthcare accounts for a large part of gerontology field in practice. As we enter in 21st century, global aging will put increased economic and social demands on all countries. At the same time, older people are a precious, often ignored resource that makes an important contribution to the fabric of our societies. The universities, research organizations, and international collaborations must to promote research and create age-friendly world in future. Every individual in this have their dignity, worthy, and right to participate and develop according to their choices. In all professionals who are working with the older people and other professionals to make confident to help older people remain healthy and active, because it is a necessity, not a luxury.